Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meakins from Naio Nails and you are watching In Bed with Kirsty! This is the third episode of In Bed with Kirsty. If you want to see the other ones, you can click the link here. So what we're going to do is do a Q&A, answer questions that you've asked me on Instagram, Facebook, and also obviously on the YouTube channel. So what's the first question, Adam?
Chrissy Pie has asked, why do nail artists prefer stiletto shaped nails?
Really? I don't know if nail artists do prefer stiletto nails. Well, maybe you see a lot of them about because we want nails to look skinny and lean and long. And the thing with, let me just put my tea down. The thing with a stiletto nail is it creates that length and that skinny thinness and it extends the fingers and makes them look long. Whereas a square nail would make the nail look more short and wide and dumpier, I would say. So maybe that's why you see a lot of them, but it's not my favourite nail. I bet everybody would guess this. At the minute, my favourite shape nail is the ballerina. It used to be an edge nail, now it's a ballerina. Times change and I just like different things. I am a sucker for a stiletto, I do like a stiletto, but yeah.
Chloral Girl. Does Kirsty have dermal piercing on that tattoo on her arm, or is it just shading of it?
So on my arm, I've got three skin divers. So they're a little bit different than a dermal anchor. A dermal anchor has a longer plate underneath it like this, and it's got little holes in it and the flesh grows through the holes. Whereas skin divers are, imagine, so you've got a stone here, a stem, and then a round plate. Now the plate sits underneath the skin and that's how it stays in, but these are easier to remove than a dermal anchor. So I chose to have skin divers because I didn't know if I always wanted to keep them in, but I've had them in for about three years now, and I love them. I used to catch them when I first had them, but I don't really catch them anymore.
Merwin Curtis asks, that's a nice name,
Merwin Curtis.
Merwin, W-Y-N, Merwin Curtis. I have a question for Kirsty's next In Bed with Kirsty. What brush size do you recommend for an acrylic beginner and what liquid? Obviously not quick drying. Adore your work. Lovely, you are so talented.
Oh, thank you for saying all those nice things about me. So, I like to use a size 8 acrylic brush. But if you're a beginner, I would probably go slightly smaller because some people find picking up, you know, the ratio of liquid to powder, they find that quite hard to do. And if you've got a smaller brush, then you can control it a little bit more. However, I think you should bite the bullet and just go for a size 6 brush from the get-go. That means you are learning straight away to use the correct brush. Now I've seen some people use like a size 10 brush and that's just ridiculous, I think. I think a size 6, size 8, that's what you should go for really. Liquid wise, with the Naio Nails, we've got quite a few different liquids. I would definitely go for Max Adhesion. I think it's a nice, it sets up nice. It's still quite pliable when it is setting. You can still move it around as long as you've got a good brush that has, you know, some stability. Basically, the shorter the brush, the more pressure you'll get with the brush. The longer the brush, the less pressure you'll get. So you want, you know, a happy medium with your brush. I definitely like a pinched brush as well, so it's crimped rather than it being round and then you have the brush going to a point here. I like it when it's pinched at the base and then it comes up into a point, if you get me. I hope you understood what I was saying. But yeah, definitely go for max adhesion. If you wanted something to set really quick, once you've become absolutely amazing at it, go for high speed.
So we made a video a few months ago called the acrylic and glitter butterfly shape, it was bloody amazing.
Kitty cat trash bag has stated,
well, that's just stunning, but how does one, very posh, how does one function in regular life with such a nail? Do people actually wear them?
Well, yes, they do, darling. They do actually wear those nails, believe it or not. I have one lady. Oh, I can't talk that.
No.
I have one lady called Steph who wears them like that, even longer than we actually did, on every single finger. That was a long set of nails. It took me quite some time to do. But yeah, people wear them. I have done them a little bit shorter. I think they look better when they are, you know, humongous and really nice and long. But I have done them shorter, and some clients just have them on the ring finger. So they just have one. So that's only one finger that they, you know, might catch or anything like that. But to be honest with you, they're so strong. You know, if you're used to nails, you'll be fine. If you have never had nails on and you go for a full butterfly nail, yeah, I don't think you could probably do much with them.
Except kill people.
Yeah, you might struggle. You've got to be an avid, you know, nail wearer to pull something like that off. Thanks for the question though, that's good.
And I just love that name. Kitty Crash, Kitty Cat, Trash Bag.
Kitty Cat, Trash Bag.
I wanna be called Kitty Cat Trash Bag. Carmisha Nash.
Carmisha Nash.
Hey, G Kirsty.
Hey, what?
It just says Haig.
Haig.
Haig, Kirsty. I wanted to know, why did you extend the nail bed, but love your work and artwork?
Ah, so why have I extended the nail bed? Right, okay. Tea needs to go down. Lots of people don't have beautiful long nail beds. Now, you know how we all want to be beautiful, slim, and not big. All these people in the world always want to be nice and lean and thin and tall. I am not tall, obviously. You know, they've not solved the problem. You know, it's not solved that for me. I can't stretch my legs and stuff. But, you know. So, it's the same with nails. Thin, long nail beds are beautiful, and we can pretend and make them with acrylic or gel. So you can extend the nail bed. It makes the fingers look longer. It makes everything look slimmer and longer. And it just looks nicer. And you need a nice deep smile line when you do this. If you did a flat one, you would look like you have a fat nail. Oh, we don't want no fat nail. We want a nice, beautiful, deep smile line that makes the fingers and the nails look nice and slim. So that's why we do it. Because it just looks more aesthetically pleasing to the eye.
You're going posh again there.
Yeah, well, I can do posh now and then, you know. Posh with my amazing Stoke-on-Trent accent. Now we're going to announce the winner from our second episode of In Bed with Kirsty. Are you listening? It is Holly Dolly Stylebrat. What a cool name. Let me just explain why we picked this winner.
Do you want me to read out what she wrote?
Yeah. We'll read it out. Let them all know. Because there's not many comments and things. You might have missed it. But everybody needs to listen to this.
Okay, so the more I get to know my fave nail tech in the industry, the more crazy it is. I've already felt a vibe with the tattoo piercings, fun coloured hair, etc. But even more in depth now, Michael Jackson is my fave artist of all time. And I have a massive tattoo on my back in memory. I had tickets for the This Is It tour. Also, I'm obsessed with sugar skulls and have multiple tattoos of them. Hashtag in bed with Kirsty, liked and shared the vid.
Awesome.
That's from Holly Dolly Stylebrat.
Brilliant. So you, I feel a connection with you. I think we, you know, I think we would like get on so well. We could chill together, and I think, you know, we'd be like really good friends. I think this girl is pretty cool. So that's why we picked it, because I was like, oh God, yeah, she's straight, you know, right down my street. So you have won this selection of goodies that I have handpicked for you. You've even got the mold that I used and my daughters used for one of the videos. So that's gonna wing its way to you. Don't forget to contact us. I want you to send us a message on Facebook or Instagram. Okay, don't forget. So that's the end of this episode, but don't go anywhere. We're gonna do a giveaway. So for this giveaway, we are going to give you the choice of either 5 gel polishes from the Urban Graffiti gel polish range or 5 acrylic powders. I will select the colours, but you're going to choose what you would like if you win. Now, to win, this is what you've got to do. You've got a hashtag. Oh, hold on, let me. Oh, the tea. Hashtag in bed with Kirsty. Like and share this video all over social media, and we will pick a winner in our next video. So I will see you all next time. Bye. Is it time for me to sleep now? I can go to bed now. Are we finished?